On the surface, it may not look like much, but look a little deeper and you might see the truth. To get a clear picture, we must go back.
I would kind of like to see AverMedia and Elgato step it up with the more beginner-friendly, cheaper capture cards. And I think it's 100% possible, but I don't think they're doing so because it would kind of sabotage their own product lineup.
It's here, the capture card you've been waiting for. 4K 60 pass-through, 1080p capture, uncompressed YUY2, 60 frames per second. All for the low, low price of just $60. It's here. The EVGA XR1 Lite. But not too light. I'm Meeples Fox, the Stream Professor, and I have reviewed countless capture cards on this channel over the years, which is why you should hit subscribe and notification buttons so you can stay informed. And a request I made in spring 2020 was for capture card companies to deliver a bare-bones capture card that worked well for under $100. We've seen a lot of capture cards hit the market, but even the most basic ones from Elgato and AverMedia stayed over that price point. And then we went on this adventure of exploring capture cards under $100, and most of them just aren't good. They pretty much all lie about being USB 3.0 when they're not. They use poor quality MJPEG encoding, and they mostly all, including the $4 million Kickstarter project raising the Genki Shadowcast and the Atomos Connect, use the same MS2109 chipset, which is quite literally incapable of actually processing 60 FPS at 1080p. And that's assuming yours didn't overheat and die a sad death because the particular one you received didn't include a heatsink. Well, EVGA stepped up. The XR1 Lite delivers this exact request I made at the start of the pandemic. This small plastic box looks unassuming. It lacks the flash and flare and the mirrored shine and the RGB clad top of the main EVGA XR1. It also lacks the cool headphone amp and mic input that made the XR1 such a good buy. But what it does have is a USB 3.0 Type-C plug and HDMI 2.0 input and pass-through.
Specs-wise, the XR1 Lite supports up to 1080p or 4K 60Hz input, scaled down for 1080p capture. If it's not cooperating with your USB 3.0 ports, such as my front panel USB ports, it may only allow you to capture up to 720p in OBS, but using ports on the back of your motherboard should resolve this. This spec is perfect for capturing the majority of game consoles out today: Nintendo Switch, PlayStation 4 and 5, Xbox One, and Series consoles. You can play at 1080p or 4K and capture and stream at 1080p or lower. It also supports 480p, more on that later. However, this capture card does not support HDR pass-through or capture. You must play in SDR and can only capture in SDR. This capture card also does not support anything higher than 60Hz. No 1080p 120 from your PC or newer consoles, and definitely no 4K 120 since that requires HDMI 2.1, and there aren't any HDMI 2.1 capture cards available. If you play at 4K 60 on PC, this will work for you as well. Both NV12 and YUY2 uncompressed modes are available over USB 3. This is great. That means you get a low latency capture to sync up with your audio more easily and no blocking or artifacting baked into your video feed before you even compress it to stream or record, something that's a big issue with most of the budget capture cards we have looked at. Super simple and basic, but that's just fine. What about 1440p?
Well, that's a little complicated. It was my original belief that they went with hardware or otherwise artificially limited this in software that did not support 1440p pass-through or capture, as did not cannibalize the market for their flagship XR1 capture card. This may still be the case, but while the spec sheet does not list 1440p support, some investigative helpers on my Discord server who got the capture card before I did, thanks to a lovely shipping hiccup on my end, 1440p actually works, but you may not be able to use it that way. Here are some screenshots, thanks Rodney, that show 1440p directly going into the capture card, and OBS still taking it in, scaled to 1080p, and the monitor on the other end receiving 1440p. However, this only works if you have a monitor whose EDID only lists 1440p or lower as being supported. That may sound silly, but my primary 1440p 144Hz monitor can actually take other higher resolutions and just awkwardly and laggily scale them down to 1440p, as can my 1440p ultrawide, which means these monitors present to the capture card, and thus the PC, as supporting 4K. Even my ancient Dell 1440p side monitor, which doesn't display anything above 1440p, does this. That one, weirdly enough. This is a problem because there's apparently a bug with how the NVIDIA control panel handles custom resolutions, where if your display reports supporting anything higher, you cannot send a true 1440p signal to it. So I have some gameplay here of my PC rendering everything at 1440p, but outputting 4K, but that's it. I have screenshot proof of the XR1 Lite accepting 1440p input and passing it through on the other end, but it's not something I can do or make happen with my hardware, and you may not either. It doesn't officially support it for a reason, clearly, but there is a chance you could make it work, especially with an EDID manipulation tool. But you're still limited to 60Hz regardless. If you're desperate for a capture card for two PC setups while you game at 1440p or high refresh rates, you could always extend your display to the capture card and then you output the OBS projector preview to the capture card instead. No tearing! One quick note, I did experience a weird issue where switching resolutions a bunch on the PC outputted to this resulted in an image that was, it eventually got misaligned like in multiple directions. It was weird, but just deactivating and reactivating the source in OBS fixed it, so not a huge deal. The EVGA XR1 Lite is a UVC capture card. This means it works plug and play without installing software and also shows up as a webcam device in Zoom, Discord, the Windows 10 camera app, NVIDIA Broadcast, and so on. This means you can use it for screen sharing, game streaming, or camera support for your favorite video conferencing app, which is pretty cool. This also means it works fine on Mac and Linux as well.
Testing the input latency to OBS's preview, I'm seeing about 78 milliseconds, which is on the higher end and will require a bit of an audio offset to sync the video up feed with whatever audio source you have. But it's not the worst thing I've encountered. I'll have a link to my stream guides page with all of these numbers in the description below, and I'll be updating these soon with more accurate testing methodologies as well. I got some work to do on this.
Quality-wise, the card looks fine. It's a little soft if you're forcing 1440p through it, likely due to the multiple rounds of scaling, but otherwise, you're getting uncompressed 1080p 60 on 420 for NV12 or 422 for YUI2, free of artifacting or pixelization. Definitely leagues better than all of the cheap MJPEG cards for under 100 bucks. It perhaps feels a tad undersaturated to my eyes sometimes, but that's easy to compensate for.
Retro gamers can rejoice. The EVGA XR1 Lite seems to be the perfect little capture card for retro games. It supports 480p from the RetroTINK 2X line of scalers and devices like the GCHD and Super 64, but it also works with all modes from the OSSC and Super Nintendo despite the weird refresh rate. 2X, 3X, 4X, and 5X all read without weird frame positioning or other issues. Plus, RetroTINK 5X users can use all modes as well, 1080p, 1200p, and 6x 1440p, and even the lower res modes. This is fantastic, as we don't often come across a card this flexible, so I'm super stoked for this. If you like what you see here on my channel, then you'd probably dig our merch. We've still got a little bit left of our limited run of high-quality blank VHS-covered desk mats, enamel pins, and stickers. Stick them on your computer, your Xbox, on your friends. Plus, you get a free trial to Nebula, my own streaming service with ad-free copies of my videos, often extended from the YouTube versions, along with your purchase. I've never done merch before this run, and I'm super stoked with what we came up with. Head on over to eposfox.gg/merch to check it out.
I'm both impressed and not impressed with the EVGA XR1 Lite. It's nothing special. In fact, it lacks everything that made the original XR1 awesome and worth it. But it also locks all the confusing complication of that XR1 with the advanced pass-through nonsense. It's just a 4K pass-through 1080p capture card that does the job. I also originally started out with this review being pretty disappointed with this, as the original launch price I was told was $100, $99.99. You know, the same price the full-size XR1 is always on sale for. I could not see myself recommending this one over its big brother for the same price. However, they launched it with an EVGA insider discount of sorts, dropping it down to $60, and it now lists on Amazon with $60 being the base price. So for that price, this card is a phenomenal deal and exactly what I requested early last year. For this price, this card maintains my Stream Professor approved badge. It doesn't do anything super special, but it delivers a quality product for a perfect price. A playlist link with other Stream Professor approved products will be linked below with the product links. While you're down there, hit the like button and join our Discord. Remember, be kind, rewind.